Thank you, Varsha. Good evening, everyone. I hope you all are safe and healthy. There were amazing sessions so far today, and I'm feeling very lucky to having this type of enthusiastic audience. The theme of the IWD event is Together We Rise. It means knowledge increases by sharing. So let's start learn something interesting together. Before starting, I would like to introduce myself. I'm Druti Joshi, working as a senior software engineer and having an experience of more than half a decade. I'm building my career as a full-stack developer and I'm facilitated by maths and logic. I'm managing a Women Packmakers chapter from Gandhinagar and also working as a co-organizer of GDG Gandhinagar. Now, without wasting more time, let's move to the topic. We all know about the Google Maps and its very basic requirement from static websites to dynamic websites. Configuration of the Google Maps in websites will almost contain at least 50 lines of codes just for a basic map. And now, if I say that we can use Google Maps in Angular just like a tag, sounds surprising and interesting, right? Actually, yes, it's very easy to use. We can use Google Map just like a text box or other text we are using. So these are the prerequisites that we need to start with the Google Maps. First, we need IDE like Visual Studio Code. Then second, we need Node.js, NPM and Angular CLI version 9.x. Then we need a good internet connection to configure the Google Maps. And last but not the least, a recent version of browser to run our application. And now these are the technologies you should be familiar with. That is TypeScript, JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. Let's go to next. Now let's start a session with a cup of tea. Confused? Actually, tea is very famous in India, isn't it? And around 4 p.m., most of the people would be habituated to have a cup of tea. You guys are wondering why I am talking about tea during the session? Well, it's lightening talk. And so sessions should be like the tea. Just like we feel fresh after drinking tea, you should definitely feel fresh after my session. We'll require 4 ingredients to make a tea. And this session will also cover 4 points. So let's consider each point as an ingredient. So the first ingredient is water, that is setting up the Google Maps. Then the second ingredient is tea, which is loading the Maps JavaScript API. Then the third ingredient is sugar, that is usage of Google Maps. And the last ingredient is milk, which is working with maps. So I've already prepared a demo project just for your better understanding. What you guys need to do is you just have to type this URL in your browser and you can see the entire demo with the source code on your screen. So that will be easy for you guys to understand. Okay, so the first point is setting up the Google Maps. And for that, we need to install Google Maps module by running the command that you can see here, which is npm install /google-maps. After running this command, you can find Google Maps folder inside the node modules folder. Then we need to import the Google Maps module in the app.module.ts file. And after that, we need to add Google Maps module in the imports array so that we can use Google Maps throughout the application. Cool, step one is completed. Let's go to the source code and see how it has been done. So here is the source code. This is my app.module.ts file. On the line number 7, you can see I have imported the Google Maps module. For that, we have to write this import statement. And after that, we have to write that component in the imports array, just like the line number 10. It's easy, right? Let's move to the next slide. It's very important step. In the same way, T cannot be made without T, Google Map cannot be used without API. We need to provide Maps JavaScript API key in our index.html. Now, question comes in your mind, that's how we get that API key. Don't worry, here is the link of the official Google document, and that will guide you how to get the API key. And it's very simple. So after getting the API key, we need to provide that key in the script tag inside the head tag of the HTML page. Great. We have completed the point number 2 as well. Now let's move to the source code and check. So this is my index.html page. You can see the script tag here, which is under the head tag. And this is my Maps JavaScript API key. Isn't it easy? I think yes, right? So let's go ahead. Now the third point is usage of Google Maps. For this, we'll create new component by running the command ng space g space c and then space name of the component. Here g stands for generate and c stands for component. This command will create 3 files. One is HTML file, second is CSS file, and third file is TypeScript file. Now we'll add Google Map component just like a tag in our HTML file. That's it. Now if you run the application, you can see default map with default functionality. Now let's go to the source code. So this is my HTML file. Okay, here you can see I have used the Google Map component just like a tag we are using, like text box, p tag, div tag, etc., etc. Right? And this is the output. Okay, so if someone like black tea, then it's ready to drink. But tea without milk is not that much delicious. Am I right? So let's go ahead. It's all about we can do more with Google Maps, and which is actually the basic requirements for all of us. Like we want our own buttons to control zoom in and zoom out. Then we want to have a marker for the current location. Then maybe want a map info window, and maybe we want to add multiple markers dynamically as well, right? So let's go ahead. First, let's add some user-defined our own custom buttons to control the zoom in, zoom out functionality. Okay. So for this, I have added 2 buttons and have created two functions. Okay. Let's go to the source code. See, here is the 2 buttons. You can see here. Okay. And here are the click events. This is called method binding. Okay. And here is the source code behind this HTML file. Okay. Let's go to the end. Here is the event. Okay. Now, maybe you wonder, what is this these.zoom and these.options.maxzoom? Okay. So these.zoom is the local property of the app.app component. And this is the property of this options object. Okay. Let's go to the top and I've explained this in detail. by default, I have set zoom property to 12. Okay. And then I have initialized one options. And I've set max zoom and max mean zoom over here. Okay. So if I click on the button, then where we can zoom and zoom out. Okay. Let's go to the output. So I can zoom out and zoom in from our custom buttons. Sounds interesting, right? Now, let's move to the next slide. Now let's add marker. Now we want to add a marker for our current location. Like I am presenting somewhere from Ahmedabad. So when I run the Google map, there would be a marker somewhere in Ahmedabad. So what we do for that? We will use navigator.geolocation.getCurrentPosition method. This will give the latitude and longitude of the current location. Now again, let's go to the source code. So here is the method navigator.geolocation.getCurrentPosition. Okay. So this will give me the current location's latitude and longitude. And we have assigned this value to the latitude and longitude. Then we have set the label object. We have set the color of the label and we have set the text of the label. Then we have set the title property and then we have set the info property. And next is options. In options, we can give the animation to the marker. We have two options over here. One is bounce and one is drop. Okay. Now, let's go to the HTML page. Okay. I have given this properties to this Google Map component. Okay. This is called property binding. Okay. We have to add a map marker tag to plot the marker for the current location. Okay, we have set all the properties like label, title, options, and position. This position will be used for plotting the current location. Okay, now let's go to the output. You can see the marker here, and it is the current location. Okay, now let's go ahead. Now, next is how to add the map info window. Now, what is the map info window? Maybe you all know. When I click on the marker, it will open up the window that is called the map info window, right? So let's go to the source code. And here I have added the map info window tag, just like other tags. Okay. Then I have created click event for the map marker because that info window should be open when I click on the marker. So I have created the click event of the map marker. Okay. So this is called method binding. Okay. And the way we have bind the content over here, it's called string interpolation. Right. So this is the method which will be called when we click on the marker. Okay. So let's go to the code. Okay, so this is the event map info window. Okay, we have the reference element here and the content which we want to display in the map info window. We have set this and we will open this when we click on the map marker window. Isn't it good? Right? So next, let's go ahead. Now, this is the basic requirement. We want to add multiple markers dynamically. Okay. And for that, we have to iterate through the objects that we have. Okay. And for this, we have used the for loop. And here it is called ng4. Okay. Now let's move to the source code. This is the event which I call when I click on the add marker button. Okay, when I click on this button, I will push all the details to the array. So this is the default behavior of the array. Okay, now I am calculating the random location by getting the latitude and longitude randomly by using the math.random. Okay, then I am setting the label property over here, title property over here, and info property over here. Here I have set the animation as a drop. Okay, now let's go to the HTML page and check how we bind this. So this is the map marker, and inside this we have returned the for loop. It will be iterated number of times that the marker has the number of elements, right? And inside that we have assigned the properties. Cool. Now let's go to the output and check. You can see when I click on the add marker button, markers will be plotted on the Google map, and we can zoom in, zoom out as well. Isn't it easy, right? So this is the final output of the source code that I have shared with you. Awesome. You guys have made your own tea. After this session, I am sure you guys can configure Google Maps in your Angular project by yourself very easily. So what we have covered today, first how we get the Google Maps module in our project, then how we configure it with the project, then how to get the Maps JavaScript API key and provide that in our index.html page. And then we will use Google Maps component as a tag in our HTML file of the component. And then we can add more feature as per our requirement. So covering all the properties for the Google Maps would be a lot for the lightning session. So if you want to go in detail, I'll refer you to go to the Google Maps API documents for the more detail and the complete list. And also there is also the source code available for the Angular implementation as well. I hope you guys find this session useful. Thank you so much to the Women Tapmakers community to give me the opportunity to spread some knowledge. Thank you so much to the amazing audience for joining me. Stay home, stay safe, and take care of yourself and family. Goodbye.